So this is chapter one, which is security governance through principles and policies, right? So let me write it down. Oops, first mistake. Security governance through principles and policies, right? Okay, so there are some heavy terms here. We all know what is security. Is to secure anything. Is the act of securing anything is security, right? What is governance? Governance is to manage or to direct or to orchestrate anything, right? So in totality, security governance is managing security or directing security or orchestrating security. How? Through principles and policies. So these two terms are very important. Principles and policies, right? So what are principles and what are policies? So if you have read one of my favorite book of self-improvement is Seven Habits by Stephen Covey. Therein he talks about principles and values of human, in human life. What are the key principles, universally accepted principles? And we derive values out of those principles, right? So any person carries some sort of value with himself. Those values are primarily derived from his belief system, religious belief, or the way he is, or the way he has perceived the life. And it's dependent, it's subjective, it's in context values, right? But the principles itself, they are self-evident. Like the principle of fairness or justice or truth. So these are universally accepted principles, and based on these principles, the value system of a person or a community or a nation is actually conceived. So this is values and principles. I will strongly recommend to read that book. It's very, very important, and it will give some sort of vision to approach different subjects as well. The way we study other things, like, it will definitely help in getting some inspiration for CISSP as well. If we try to correlate what are the concepts, key concepts discussed there, and how it works in the realm of information security. Yeah, so this was just a side note. Let me rub it out. So we discussed security governance through principles and policies. So principles are the key concepts of information security realm, right? And based on these key concepts, we derive the policies, we make policies, and what happens, these policies in turns help governance. So let me line here. So these policies help in governing security of an organization. So understanding the chapter heading is also very important, right? This gives you a sort of compass, like how we navigate this chapter and what is expected out of the chapter. In fact, if you read the book, there is a brief paragraph which talks about what is in this chapter. But if we just stop and think and ponder over what this heading is and what is being achieved with this chapter, it will be more beneficial, and we will get more out of the book, right? So what are the principles, security principles, and what are the policies we will further explore in the next video? So stay tuned and let's meet in the next video.